said, "So it is better not to interfere, Damanaka. It is for us, who serve the king, to assist him with the right advice," said Damanaka. "You know very well that this is a task for the king's prime minister, not us," argued Karataka. "We should not try to do the work that is not given to us. After all, the prime minister tells us our tasks. If we take over his role, we will get into trouble. If we try to do other people's work, our fate will be the same as the washerman's ass." "What washerman's ass?" asked the Manaka. "Don't you remember the one who tried to take over the work of the washerman's dog?" asked Karataka. "Do tell me the story," said the Manaka. "I don't remember it at all, so I don't know what you are talking about." The Washerman's Ass. In Banaras, there lived a washerman who had an ass and a dog. The ass was always complaining because he was kept tied to a post, whereas the dog was free to walk around wherever he pleased. One night, when the washerman was fast asleep, a thief crept into the house. The ass was very concerned because the dog didn't bark. So he prodded the dog to bark. "You leave me alone," said the dog. "The master doesn't feed me properly. If something gets stolen, he'll realize the value of having a dog to guard his house." "You selfish fellow," said the ass. "You are being disloyal. I will wake him up." And the ass began to bray loudly. His master woke up in a rage. The thief ran, so the washerman did not see him. He picked the cudgel up and beat the poor ass to death. Damanaka persuades the reluctant Karataka. "I agree that this is the prime minister's job," Karataka admitted Damanaka after hearing the story. "But we must rise to high positions. We can only do that if we make some effort." Karataka was not very convinced, so Damanaka gave a lot of arguments to persuade him. "People work to achieve different things, my friend," said the cunning Damanaka. "Some people work for wealth, some for affection. Look at a dog. He will roll on the ground and wag his tail just to please his master. But we have to work for a greater ambition." "What ambition?" asked Karataka. "We wish to be ministers to the king," replied Damanaka. "And for that, we must take action and make a big effort, mustn't we?" Finally, Karataka asked him what he proposed to do. The jackal's plan begins. "So, now what do you propose to do?" asked Karataka. "We must find out what has frightened the king," suggested Damanaka. "Even if we have to risk going to him, I will see what his mood is and then put across some plan to make him pleased with me." "Be careful, Damanaka," warned his friend Karataka. "I will," assured Damanaka. "I will patiently follow the king like a shadow, and when he is pleased with me, I will ask him what worries him." So Damanaka went to the Lion King's den and bowed low before him. When the king asked him to enter, he went in and sat down. He humbly told the king he had come to serve him. Damanaka flattered the king and finally asked him why he had returned without a drink of water. The king, impressed by him, told him that he heard some beast roaring and didn't know what it was.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.